Hey everyone, Mherex here, bringing you another video. This one is going to be the deep dive on Cora Jade. You can see I'm going to start off with no strap. In the comparison for living Cora, I think for you to make a good decision, it's going to come down to what you have. And the thing is, with nothing, Cora hits super hard and is very, very reliable. So I think this first build set will probably answer a lot of questions for people with no strap. Entourage, my free-to-play account, actually has all of these characters. Let's start with the moveset. Jaded 10 MP finisher, and deal 446k damage, make 37 trap gems into red. Diving senton, deal 124k damage, make 35 random gems into trap gems. If broken by your opponent, deal 89k damage and increase the damage of all your gems by 20% for 2 turns. If broken by you, steal up to 84k health. And then the chokehold, 7 MP submission, choose 7 gems to make into purple sub gems, do 268k damage 3 turns. You use the sub to load the finisher, and then you throw your traps out. And let's say you break all 37 traps. Let me pull my calculator up, 37 at 84k. That's 3 million just in the heal damage. Right there. Plus you have your move damage and, you know, your red gem damage and all that. So Entourage is Butch, Davy Boy for red gems and 2 red MP. So we're going to start loaded. Stacy is flat 12k gem damage, and Steamboat makes those traps hit a lot harder since you're breaking so many and create 2 more. It's perfect, actually. We're going to go out here against an acrobat. And no perks on this account, so this would mirror feud perks. You can see just 1 MP on Jaded. Both of these start loaded. You're going to hold your trap gems for this build. So if you get a board like this, you would put your trap gems out. I'll show you why. Because I got a feeling that we are going to be able to totally recycle the red. Yes, we are. So if you ever get a board like that, you would do that. You can see we've now buffed the red gem damage a little bit. And then you're going to throw your traps out and then hit the finisher. And you get a board like that, and this is just kind of good night right here. She has 9 million health left. All the way, that was a 9.2 million hit with no strap. Granted, that's a perfect scenario. And not easy to pull off, so we'll just run it again. But I think you kind of get the idea that this is very strong even without a strap. No question, this is a better move after playing these both a bunch, Liv and Cora, on my free-to-play account to take Cora up with this moveset. No question. So normally you would just do your sub, couple 3 matches, 3 3-matches. In fact, to load your finisher. So she's got 11 mil health left, and let's see how hard this hits. With no strap, 7.5 mil. She might kick out. Because she's cascading a lot? Nope, she did not. So, that's pretty great. The one thing to note about Cora is the gem damage isn't going to go up a ton at silver. So, with that, with this build, you'll probably hit for another million or two at 6-star silver. With no strap, maybe like a mil to 2 mil with this build. So, also, strapless, let's say you do... you probably don't have Nakamura. Let's just say, so the reason why I wouldn't run this build is because you need Santa Hogan to make it work. And this is kind of the traditional way that I really like for speed. But you start 1 MP short on the finisher because the back elbow smash only increases your purple MP by 8. So if you don't have a 17k Santa or a line bonus, I think this is your build for Cora right here. Strap or no strap, I think this is the one. So that's it without a strap. It's not going to be significantly harder with a strap, but it will be better. So let's just go ahead and put a 20%er on that I do have prepared. Right here. It does have the purple move damage strap. Of course, you could use all heart with this. You're also going to see this boat plate on here. We're going to use that with the next build. Shout out to Gluis, because I don't have a boat plate, and he told me about this build, and you can make it work most of the time. We'll do that next, but this is basically just to show the damage with a strap and metals and see how much harder than 7.5 mil you can hit with this setup. If you have a strap in metals, and it's just a 20% gem damage strap, nothing crazy. But yeah, this is going to be much easier, to load lots of purples out here. Of course, you could use all heart. To buff the reds, that would work great. You can also use all hard and sheriff's badge. But yeah, maybe I'll just throw those on after this. But we did 7.5 million. And you can see with a strap, we did 10 million. A lot of that would be from the move damage metal, to be honest. So that's that move set with a strap, a 20%er. Because that move damage made the finisher like 1.2 million move damage, gained like 800. Actually, more like 900k on it. So let's say you want to run this and then with a strap and you have Nakamura. You'd replace Nakamura with Steamboat. Although Steamboat adds a lot on those traps, right? For sure. Let's see the difference there. And throw Nakamura on. Basically, it's this moveset right here. Boom. So that doubles the health on the health steal from 80 whatever K to 169 K, basically 170 K. And let's see if we can wipe her health with that trainer change, coach change rather. You can see finisher doing 1.2 million with the move damage metal, 200%. So she's at 11.2 million. Let's see if we wipe the health. No, 10.8. So really negligible between Steamboat and Nakamura, actually. And Steamboat isn't max there. He's at 6-star bronze, so you can get 25% more. So that's kind of interesting, right? Okay, now this is going to be a shout-out to Gluis here, and I will run this with and without Steamboat. If you have the boat status plate, what happened on the board the first time is much easier to pull off. Whenever you break 3 or more purple gems, increase your red MP by 3. So we just need to break 3 red gems along with 3 purple any way we can to recycle. And then you can also get the buff going. Let's see if we can make it happen, Cap'n. Not ideal for what I normally would do. We just need to get... So there's a chance the wild card falls here, but it's not a perfect chance. We're gonna go with that. That's 5, 6, 7, 8, which is enough. Let's just break those two. Let's go with that. No, we're gonna go corner. All right. So you can see that refilled, and now she's breaking the trap gems, which is buffing our gem damage 160%. So shout out to Gluis there. With the boat status plate, it's much easier to pull that off. You can the majority of the time. And the gem damage is significantly harder here. You can see we totally wiped her health. And that was 7 million gem damage on top of the damage from the health steal. With Nakamura would be like 6 million, right? So that's like 13 million damage ish without the finisher. So very, very good if you can do that. Very fast. That actually scales pretty well into silver. And Steamboat is going to scale better with this than Nakamura as well. So if we throw Steamboat back on here, you're going to get even more gem damage. Of course, there's going to be big variance depending how many traps they break. But I'll run it again just so you can see. And honestly, even though I generally don't like sub builds, this would be your most consistent build at silver, even over the regular build, unless there's boosts. So this is perfect. This is what you want to see. This makes it really easy to recycle. If you ever see two reds here on the bottom, that's perfect. That's really easy. That's our wildcard drops. We have our red recycle. So now we're good. There we go. Looks like we got 9 traps broken again. That's very good. 180% buff. So we're at 157k per red, and we're going to change most of the board there. Very nice. And that was 9 million in gem damage with Steamboat. So Steamboat is definitely the play for this one, and a 20% strap. With the 9 million gem damage, that's 18 million in gem damage at silver with a 20% strap. You do have to use the sub. And again, there's variances because of how many traps get broken. But honestly, at silver, that's probably her best set. If not her fastest. So the one that I typically use is this one. It does need 17k Santa Hogan. And I've been using Nakamura because my Steamboat isn't leveled up. So let's run this one. And I will show you what this looks like. This one doesn't scale particularly great. It doesn't hit much harder at silver. If you have the NXT moment, it does a lot better. Because you get a, 125% boost to reds and yellows, and then you put a sheriff's badge. So you can run this pretty effectively with a high gem damage strap, NXT moment, sheriff's badge, and stuff. But let's take a look what it looks like without it. You do need 17k Santa or a line bonus in feud, because for some reason, and I don't know why Cora is this way, almost every other card we've had in the past, I don't know how long, this would be 9 MP, but hers is only 8. So it leaves you 1 MP short in feud without Santa or a line bonus. So you absolutely need Santa. And I'll show it with Nakamura, and then we'll show it to you with Steamboat. And then we'll put a couple other plates on, because this is like the speed build. I wish I had a silver to go against just for the health. Because like at 6-star bronze, this is great, right? Super easy to use. Boom. Boom. Finisher's doing 1.34 million. You can also use Chelsea plate on this. 9.5 million. At silver, that probably is only about 11 or 12 mil. And we did miss a few traps, so I'll run it one more time. NXT moment gets you up to about, I want to say, usually like 14 mil. Sheriff's badge gets you 15, 16 mil. With a 30% strap. That's typically what I do in feud. If there's ever a red bonus boost or a yellow with the sheriff's badge, she does much better in feud with the NXT moment. So you can run this setup with some really nice stuff pretty effectively turn one very quickly. This has got a lot of reds on the board. Of course, you can also use Seance if you had that. I'm not going to put a Seance on. You guys know that. But the point being, straps, there's 11 million. That was much better. Okay, the point being, straps don't really change this a lot. They do some, but there's nothing to really multiply the gem damage at this point with this build, right? So let's go ahead and try that with Steamboat. Steamboat, I think, is not going to be as good as he was with the buff. But let's find out. We'll do a couple as well, just so you guys can see. $8.3 million, and we left a few on the board, and one more because that was similar to the first one. I do think for sure Nakamura is better currently with what we have equipped. That could change when we put some plates on. And keep in mind, this Santa that's on here is a big boy Santa. So yours won't hit as hard as this Santa does for sure. This is great for bronze, 6-star bronze, and it kind of peaks there at 6-star bronze. I really think this sub build is going to probably be people's best success. And I dislike saying that unless you're going against bronzes, but it's true. 8.8 million. Yeah, Nakamura is your play here over Steamboat for what this setup is. Okay, and last thing before I start putting some maybe bigger plates and stuff on, there's this countdown build, which I think is worth mentioning for a couple reasons. One, if anyone at Scopely sees this, the countdown move is broke for hardcore. So they're running Hurricane Rana. You read this. Hardcore, if opponent style is chaotic, first deal 178k damage and then decrease all of your countdown gem timers. So when that happens, you don't get the bonus damage for your countdown gems, which is no bueno. So you miss out on damage there. So if that would be fixed, this would be much, much better against chaotics, because you'd get extra damage. The countdowns themselves are twofold deal. Make 22 random gems into one turn countdown that will deal 178k damage. That's 178k times 22. So they do good damage when they go off. And then they, they make 3 random gems into purple. So they turn the whole board purple. And then you're going to use this move here. That's only 5 MP. So it's really low charge. And it increases your blue MP by 6. The reason this one, like, Judgment Day plate, Z plate, combo. You could absolutely run this if you wanted to. I know a lot of people actually really like this build set. I don't run it myself, at all, but it is really low charge. Of course, Z plate would buff the purples more. Judgment Day plate would drain their MP. And let me just show you guys what this looks like against a non-chaotic. Again, the chaotic move, the bonus damage for every countdown doesn't work. That get fixed, she would be amazing against chaotic. But I do like that it's super cheap MP. Chuck your countdown gems out. Sorry, I had a mild brain fart there. And then this does like 3.3 million damage with this setup. 3.7. I was a bit off. And then you're going to swipe. And now your countdown gems go off, which does a bunch of damage, and then 2.5 million in gem damage. So that was 6 million in countdown, 2.5 in gem. And you can see the end result is pretty much the same as the other stuff. So that's one where Z-Plate or Jade Plate and a Judgment Day Plate would let you take that swipe. So let's just start there with the plates. Somebody asked to see the Jade Plate on it. So let me just start there with this build set, because this isn't one I normally run. I've never actually ran a Jade Plate on her, to my knowledge. Like, maybe I did when the Jade Plate came out, and I don't remember. So you could definitely do the Jade Plate. I'm not going to put the Judgment Day Plate on. You know what that does. It drains their MP. Whenever you make six or more countdown gems, deplete six MP from all of their moves, right? And then, of course, if you're targeting Chaotic, so much the better. Except for if you're targeting Chaotic, you would change Ridge to purple, and then Rhea to, like, whoever you have that generates purple, like Showboat Lacey, which I'll probably run one that way if you want to target Chaotic so you could have an idea just a turn later, is what this will do. So we did 3.4 million gem damage, 6.6 total. So we gained about 500k in gem damage. Not crazy. let's mix it up just slightly here for you guys. And let's go all gem damage. I didn't plan on going this in-depth on this one, but now that I'm in here, I feel like I probably should, because I know there'll be some people that really like this moveset, so let me at least show you gem damage-wise what you can expect. You want to use flat purple here at this level for sure. There. Nope, that's not it. Dang it, Will. I really need a surge feature in this one. There we go. Razor is like 50 more, but, you know, we'd have to look. And then since we're going to index this, let's do Cody for 30% purple gems. This with like a hundo strap and a Judgment Day plate would probably hit really solidly. My best trickster strap is 30% though. We're not going to end up doing too much damage here now. It was, it's like 1.5, right? We were much higher. Let's see if we make it up there. 4 million gem damage and a bigger pin. So that 4 million gem damage with this setup would go to like 8 million at silver. Not really where you want to be. The damage from the countdowns would stay about the same. So yeah, I maybe with a hundo strap, I guess. But let's look at... Oops, wrong button. Let's go back to the traditional one now. That's not the right spot, Mherex. There we go. And then I'm jumping around a little bit. Hopefully this all makes sense for you guys. The moment, like I said, is really big for her. It's feud only, though. Let's go back to this setup. So, for this setup, I also didn't mention you don't recycle the finisher, without the raucous cooking plate. Or unless you cascade, right? So this would be the primary plate you would use for this setup, ideally, all the time, even though I didn't mention that first time through. And then the secondary plate, you have a few choices for the ultimate. You could run the Chelsea plate, which gives 200% move damage when you use your traps, which ends up being 800k. Not that big a deal at silver. That's not the right play. You'd want Sheriff's Badge with or without the NXT moment. So this will give you a better idea on the gem damage with the sheriff's badge. I was 4 million in gem damage, and completely wiped her health. So, you know, 11 million, that's probably like 14-ish, maybe. I don't know, like I said, it just depends how it hits. In feud at 6-star silver with a 30% strap in this setup and an NXT moment, mine typically hits for like 16 to 17 mil. At silver with this kind of setup and a 30% strap. I think if you have like, well, let's see how much difference 100 makes instead of say, I think, because we did 4 million in gem there. So let's just go with 100. This is the 100. But she's really smooth. I do think for most people, though, like I said, the sub build is going to be the most efficient way to go, especially without a moment. I don't feel like I really need to add more stuff, but I probably will do an all heart build too. So you guys can see that. Here. Yeah, and like I said, Chelsea plate's only going to add like 800-900k damage, so not that great. Don't need to put it on. Not going to scale much to silver. That's what you're going to get. You're going to get about 800-900 more k with the Chelsea plate. Sheriff's badge is much, much better option. So this is this build with 100%er. We were doing, what'd we do, 4 million, that last one, right on the edge of 4 million gem. Let's see what we do here. Going up 80% on the plate. $4.5 million. So that's 9 million gem at silver. And then you got your 7 million from your heal gems. And then your 1.4 million on your finisher. So yeah, that's what it looks like at silver. 100 strap doesn't make a huge, huge difference there. I feel like the, like I said, this one right here is going to be the play for most people if you have the boat plate in particular. Let's go back to that 20 or all heart, either or, depending how you want to run it. Let's go back. That's not the right button. And put an all heart on. Since that is still set up ish. Where are you? Why am I so blind? Guess I removed all the plates. This one? You know what? Let's just have some fun with this, actually. Let's just keep this one on. Why not? Let's do this with the boat plate and then without. And the all heart in place of it. Keep the sheriff's badge because it actually works on the finisher. And let's use We're gonna have, yeah, this is the boat plate. So let's replace this with steamboat. Since we are using the boat plate. Sometimes you have to get creative in how you get your matches. This should drop all of them where we need them. Like so. And this time, she did not break very many traps at all. Only two. So this one's not going to hit as hard as it could, for sure. Because that was only two traps broken. That was 7 million, and that, if you remember right, that's about what we hit with 9 traps broken with the 20% strap. So let me run that one more time. I know this video is kind of long, but I think like it's important for people trying to decide between Cora and Liv. And maybe you got some nicer stuff and you're just curious what the top end is here. This is perfect. Here. Makes our recycle easy. We can leave a lot of traps, hopefully. 3, 3, 3. And hopefully she'll break a bunch. Oh, wow. Goodness. That's a bunch. 14. That's a 14. $257,000 each. And it also applies to the yellow, I think. It's all gems. Yeah, it's all gems. So this is going to hit super hard. Oh boy. That's 20 million gem damage. So, you pick your opponents right if you want to use this, though. Double check, make sure they don't have an escape artist, and make sure they don't have any swipe and get the color MP to get loaded during the sub. And I think you're going to have super good success with that set. Like, and whether you have the... I don't have the boat plate, so even if you don't have the boat plate, then just switch up instead of that to the all heart. And I'll run this a couple times, too, and we'll call it good. But I think for most people at Silver, this is going to by far be the best set. Of course, if you have some crazy stuff, you can get away with the traditional one. But for most people, this is probably the money at Silver. Again, at Bronze, the quick way is more than sufficient. And you can also look for ways to potentially make those reds when the board works out. But normally you're going to hold your trap gems back for after the sub. 3, 3, 3. Sure. So all heart, when you make sub gems like that, increases your purple gem damage by 100% if you didn't know. Purple and green. I'm sorry. That's the wrong plate. I said all heart a bunch of times. I want the Bulldog Gremlin plate for red gems. You don't ever listen to Mherex. He doesn't know what he's talking about. Every time I said all heart in this move, this preview, it was dog ear gremlin plate. So yeah. If you have the Sheriff's badge, you could also do Rhonda's jacket for black and yellow. Since you're getting 30 yellows, red's a little bit better, because we're also focusing on red trainers, and steamboat with the red trap. So let me try this again with the right plate, the dog ear gremlin plate. Dog ear gremlin. I know there's going to be people that don't watch the whole video. They're going to be like, dude, you said all heart. And they'll be like, yes, I know I did. But I changed it at the very end when I put the plate on and ran it wrong. But you didn't watch the whole video, so you didn't know that. If you're listening right now, let me know that you heard this. That I did, in fact, watch the whole video. So I know it's supposed to be the dog ear gremlin plate. I'm smarter than Mherex. So this case, boom, we can get our red match, so you would certainly want to take it. Anytime you can, you gotta take those. I mean, we didn't get much of a boost, only 4, but still. That was 10 million gem damage with only 4. And let's run it one time right now. Like, or not right, but, you know, I don't know how often that's going to happen in matches where you can guarantee getting the traps twice on the board. Probably not a lot. Maybe 1 in 5, 1 in 10. But it's just good to be aware that it's there. Potentially, you know? Let's just make a big old mess. Why not? And, whoops. Those red gems are doing 80k after the Bulldog Gremlin plate sub. And Bulldog Gremlin is red and blue, by the way. So that's 5.6 million gem damage, or 11 million at silver. So there you go. I think that's probably sufficient, so you have an idea how Cora is going to run. I think most rosters, this build with a boat plate can be particularly nasty. Again, shout out to Glues for that. I don't have a boat plate, so I'd never tried that before he mentioned it to me. So really like that. I don't usually love the sub gameplay, but I feel like for her, for most rosters, it's really good. And this is the setup that I have on my free-to-play and could run. Definitely on my free-to-play, I think Cora is by far the better choice than Liv. And even on my main account, to be honest, with the 30% strap that I have, I can do way more with Cora than I can with Liv. Liv, I can technically hit harder if I want to do all the matchy stuff and stack the buff twice. But that gets really clicky and it just takes a long time. And I can, with this setup, with what I have on my main, do reliably 16 to 18 mil all the time with a 30% strap. But again, that's with the moment and the sheriff's badge plate. Hopefully this video helps you guys decide which one is right for you. I want to keep doing these deep dive videos, so please let me know what you think, if they're useful, if they're helpful. I know this one is super duper long. Sorry about that. But thanks for watching, guys, and good luck out there. Cora's really fun. I like her a lot. If you're also listening to the end of this, Chelsea is my favorite lady trickster. I think she's the best, but I definitely like Cora a lot.